April 20, 2017, calendar of Pope Gregory. And we're standing here on the convening of the preparatory meeting by the Global Indigenous Women's Caucus here in front of the United Nations in New York, territories of the Lenape, territories of the Haudenosaunee, territories of the original nations of the Great Turtle Island. We're standing here in the 2017 year, they say it has been way longer than that, the history of humanity and the memory of that history, the memory of that generation of our very humanity, which goes back not just to 2 or 3 or 5 or 10,000, we're talking about time immortal. And in that culture, that identity that we have as beings of earth, the human, our ancestral people of the indigenous nations, the original nations of indigenous peoples, with the original seed, the original ecology of human society planetarily. This edifice, this institution called the United Nations barely got here in the 50s after World War II. We ourselves, we got here in 1973 with the independent Oglala Nation sending the chiefs to come here to take presence as one of the nations of Mother Earth in this institution of the United Nations, to have our voice be heard in reference to the standing as nations that is codified and articulated and documented by the treaties that we have with the United Nations system states, for example, the United States of America and the 1868 treaty, which was the case at the Wounded Knee issue of 73, the standoff, the firefight, the deaths, the blood on the ground, 1851 treaty also with Fort Laramie. They didn't even get to the door. They had the cops who were lined up here to prevent the chiefs of the Wounded Knee Nations to getting inside even to the sidewalk. But now we're here in 2017, 46 years, I think it is now. And they're talking about it, that they're going to be discussing in this session of the UN Permanent Forum on Indigenous Issues. At this session, they're going to be discussing the 10th anniversary of the Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples that was proclaimed by the UN in 2007, 10 years ago. Now, a declaration, let's understand that. A declaration of the United Nations, such as, for example, the Declaration on the Rights of Women, or of any type of declaration that the UN system would propose to adopt and finally become ratified at the General Assembly level, which happened in 2007 with the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples. That declaration would then lay the framework, the foundational framework, to set the standards of what would then be at a next point in the process, a convention, an international binding convention with mechanisms to redress the crimes against that convention if those stipulations are violated. Right now we have a declaration. The convention was down the road. In the meantime, what has happened is the UN system is instituted through the high-level plenary meeting of the states, a process that they're calling the system-wide action plan, what I call the swap at the UN. They're swapping out the trajectory of getting to a convention. It would take us, it took us 20, 30 years from 73 to now to get to the declaration. It would take another 20 or 30 years at least to get to a convention, possibly most likely more. But the main fact is this. Indigenous people's rights, as rights that we have the right of memory. We have the right to remember why and how we got here, who sent us here, and what our relationship is to this United Nations as a system. Let's talk about it. The Roman Empire has fallen. The Holy Roman Empire as well has faded away. And in that moment in the history of Europe, what's to be done, what's left? You have the sovereignties of the kingdoms of the states fading, of the kingdoms of the kings fading away, and what was put in place in Westphalia in 1648. Look it up, Westphalia 1648, the Westphalian system was the transfer, the concept of sovereignty from the king. They took the crown off the king, they got rid of the king, they kept the chair. They made that a state and they call it the concept of state sovereignty. The Westphalian system 1648, that's what that is. The United Nations system is a direct descendant, talking about ancestry, right? derivative of the Westphalian system of state sovereignty 1648. It comes out as a result of the collapse of the Roman Empire, the fading away of the Holy Roman Empire, the assimilation into powers of the kingdoms of Europe in the times of the Middle Ages, and then the insertion into power of the state sovereignties of the republics. And now we're at the point where even that institution has been subsumed under the international trade agreements of the financial institutions and the global mechanisms of capitalism, of marketing of the natural resources of Mother Earth and our people. So today we're standing here in anticipation of the session of the Permanent Forum on Indigenous Issues to determine what role of participation here at the United Nations, with the United Nations, what is it? Because according to all the documents that are being presented to us as far as celebrating our enhanced participation, for example, the concept that's being discussed, or our recognition as indigenous peoples, this is one thing that did happen. The declaration in 2007 established us as indigenous peoples. For the first time, peoples was given to us as a recognition in terms of also equal to all of the peoples within that system. That means the right of self-determination should also, by inference, by common logic, also be the same as all of the peoples. But the UN system is denying us that right. We're not being allowed to go forward to the trajectory of the convention. It's being shut down, it's being cut short, and being sidetracked to provide a system-wide action plan. This is what the discussion here is going to be about within a few days. In that process, today the Global Indigenous Women's Caucus is convening, analyzing, reviewing, and remembering, and recalling to all of us, the indigenous nations, the Mother Earth, the importance of the protection of the sacred spirit of water, world of water, one. It was very plainly said this morning at the Indigenous Peoples, the Global Indigenous Women's Caucus. The water that falls from the sky, the rains that fall, that form the rivers, that go to the aquifers, that provide the springs, and that eventually through the sacred rivers of Mother Earth arrive to their destination of origination again at the sacred sea, that we can have the sacred sight of knowing what it is to be human, carriers of the spirit of water, voices for the spirit of the sacredness of water. And in that power of resonance, we have to say, yes, their governments, yes, their states. It's a government state system where the concept of Westphalian state sovereignty is embedded institutionally. And the question is, according to what we're being told, we're being allowed enhanced participation at the United Nations. At the United Nations. Not with the United Nations, not in the United Nations, but in what role do we have? So their governments, their states, and we are the nations. We are the nations of Mother Earth. And our system of nationhood, our right of self-determination as nations of indigenous peoples, original nations of indigenous peoples, the Mother Earth, supersedes that system. It cannot be constrained by the system, but we can work with them as long as we're working towards the common goal, which is what? That institution was put in place after World War II, after the horrors of World War II, with the concept at the forefront of world peace, to avoid the bloodshed of war. Has that occurred? We know it has. We know it has. We're now entering another era of warfare at a higher dimension, where we are being asked to sacrifice the future generations for the bottom line corporate benefit of certain elites and financial institutions that depend on their financial sustainability to make a profit at all times. At what cost? At what cost to the earth? At what cost to the future generations? And this is the real question. We are all facing this question. The UN system is facing this question. The climate crisis of climate chaos is upon us all. And in that crisis, there is no they. It is not no us and them. It's the same air, the same water, the same natural world that we all share. So we have to find a way to come back into balance, homeostasis, because if, like the United Nations, we want peace on Earth. We cannot have peace on Earth if we are not at peace with Mother Earth. That means we must come back to regenerate a relationship on a spiritual dimension, on a material dimension, on a cultural dimension, on a political dimension, and on a people dimension, to understand that our nationhood as indigenous nations is what must guide us in terms of our international agenda of activities of solidarity, of alliance, and of geopolitical positioning in terms of what role we have to play in global society. We know that when the chiefs were sent here in 1973 to get the 1868 Treaty of Fort Laramie inscribed into the body of international law of that system, we know that this has not yet occurred. You're going to hear a lot of talk over the next few days over the final outcome document that came out of the Alta Conference in Norway. The final outcome document that came out of the high-level plenary of the United Nations of the states that took place and has led to this agenda here today. A lot of it will be spoken about that final outcome document, but using our right of memory, we will say this again. We want to see the original documents instituted first. We want to see the treaties of our nations with the government state systems put at the forefront of this relationship of our nations and the systems of the UN. Until that occurs, and without that occurring, we cannot say that we have advanced our agenda with the cognition and then recognition, I want to say it, cognition and then recognition of our nationhood as original nations of Mother Earth, indigenous peoples, in terms of our relationship to that system, that constituency, and all other human beings and living beings on the planet. With that in our heart, in our hand, in our mind, we stand here again like we did in 73, the treaties, the treaty relationship, the original document, that's what has to be instituted before we can advance with that system. And in the meantime, we will communicate, we will converse, we will dialogue, we will attempt to make understanding of who and why we are here in order to defend the sacredness of Mother Earth, the sacredness of the water, World Water One, Water is Life, Tupac Gobekoyo, Ayo.